Alrighty, well, hi everybody, and back on again in time for some more Gems of War. This is gonna be kind of a messed up session. It's probably gonna be a fairly long intro, cause, I got a thing or two to say. Oh, for those that don't know, normally on a work day, I'm typically not on. Once in a while, I'm on a day like today, cause, I mean, I pretty much have to do a class trial, but yeah, I got home from work, laid down around 8 a.m. I only got maybe a couple hours, like I woke up around 10:30 a.m., so 2.5 hours. Couple reasons. One, just sinus congestion issues, so yeah, that, been sneezing up a storm as well, so I'm thinking a sinus infection maybe, but yeah, and then secondly, apparently, one of my coworkers, I don't even want to call her a coworker because we work in different departments, but apparently she's got some kind of beef against me. Like I said, I put timestamps in the description for a reason, so anyway. She's had a beef with me for many, many years. In fact, many years ago, if I was to venture a guess, probably about, I'd say roughly 7 or 8 years ago, I got called to the office. Hey, you need to stay away from this person. You can't take your breaks or lunches with this, when she's around and stuff like that. Despite the fact that I hadn't done a thing to her, just my mere existence. So yeah, that kind of reared its ugly head. Apparently, she still got the beef. Again, I'm not doing anything to her. Just, getting up, winding down my lunch break, she's coming on, like, stop staring at me, or something like that. She's got a thick Asian accent. I have a hard time understanding her. I think that's what she said. So, yeah, so, a bit stressed about that, because this has happened before, getting called to the manager's office, telling me, hey, you're creeping her out, and, really lame. Kind of lame. I mean, I can say that too, because in the many years in the retail business, I work with a lot of assholes. Not once have I ever gone to management to complain about them. I just tolerate their bullshit. So I have every right to call her out for being an entitled Karen, for lack of a better phrase. So, but anyway, this has been on my head, so. Needless to say, it's short sleep. Like, normally on a day like this, I sleep like a baby, coming home from work, laying down at 8 a.m. But not this time. And then the aforementioned sinus problems as well. So, yeah. And like I normally do these days, in fact, I tried doing it. Woke up at 10:30 a.m. Try to lay back down for an hour, and just ended up tossing and turning. So when that happens, fuck it, just get out of bed, get a stream going. So it's noon right now. Got up around 11:30 a.m. and just again got a stream going. So yeah. So this is basically an impromptu session. I hadn't planned on doing this, at least not until like 2:30 p.m. But again, all the aforementioned stuff happened. So, but like I said, there was a slight chance that I was gonna do an afternoon stream anyway, because I think I need to do the class trial, and I'm trying to get my Orb Weaver class over at least 80, so I can upgrade the power level in the Zul'Kari Kingdom. So what I had already plan on being on for a while, just not this early. So, and then another thing too is I do have to use my cell phone for my Twitch app, my tablet. It's done it before. It's completely seized up to a point where in order to restart it, I have to basically leave it set out in the open and let the battery run down to zero till it then shuts off. So, God help me if this, God help me if my cell phone fucks up now. But yeah, that's on the agenda. Doing the dailies, the class trial, and then going from there. And then something else too, DJ Screw, or here, let me do something real quick. I think I forgot to do it. I forgot to do it while setting up my stream. Okay, and then something else, probably before I even get into the game, DJ Screw gave me he shot me a video. It's like a 7.3 update or something. I figured since I had it up and set up and everything, I might as well just go ahead and watch it during the stream.
Grab your greatswords, hold on to your hauberks, and join me for a preview of...
Okay, I'm gonna run this video for a moment or two. I need to check the sound level on it. Chances are I might end up having to jack it up or turn it down. I don't know yet.
The Gems of War 7.3 update. Let's start small and work our way up. The first feature is a new status effect, Terror.
Alright, so...
Once a troop is afflicted with terror,
okay.
One of two things can happen.
Okay, so it looks like it's all loud enough, so let me go ahead and start it over from the beginning. Oh, hey, what's up, Martyr? Yeah, it just occurred to me, he's... Little drunky wonky, huh? Okay, but anyway, let me go ahead and get this video going. It's
Hello, adventurers, it's Sirion here. Grab your greatswords, hold on to your hauberks, and join me for a preview of the Gems of War 7.3 update. Let's start small and work our way up.
Okay, Terror.
Next feature is a new status effect, Terror. Once a troop is afflicted with terror, one of two things can happen. If the troop is in the last slot, it has a 10% chance to flee the battle each turn.
In the last chance? So basically he's gonna go all gnome and take off on me. Hope he doesn't take the loot with him. Yeah, Kitaro, but, not for the best of reasons. I mean, I'm on a lot earlier than I wanted to be, but I kind of explained it at the start of the video, or at the start of the stream.
Not in that last slot. It has a 10% chance to move down towards it every turn. Of course.
Okay, I saw it.
Chance to order
yeah.
Things.
I'll have to watch that later.
And now for some dragons. 10% chance to...
So let me back this up a bit. I gotta... It's a new status effect in this game. So I kinda... Need to look it over. Yeah. Probably the least desirable role, Martyr. Tank.
The troop is in the last slot. It has 10% chance to flee the battle each turn. But if it's not in that last slot, it has a 10% chance to move down towards it every turn. Of course, Terror has the usual chance to auto-cleanse. And now for some dragons.
Yeah, it's my favorite role.
7 new cosmic dragons with an egg in the soul.
Oh, okay, so, yeah, this is just gonna be a another tier, basically another dragon tier. You had regular chromatic dragons, for lack of a better word, and now we got looks like we got cosmic dragons.
Fun with those gem dragons, so we thought it was time for some new dragons to craft with Dragonite. So we present the 7 cosmic dragons themed around various astronomical bodies and elements, such as comets, stars, and nebulae. These guys cost a little more than...
Wait, let me out. Let me read this over. Okay, so yeah.
They're gem dragon counterparts, but they're a little tougher too. Now for an intro to our big PvP update. 7.3 is the first step in a series of updates to PvP, which we'll be doing through much of 2024. When you press the PvP button, the world map will change. Kingdoms will disappear, and instead you will see 10 regions where PvP now takes place. We'll discuss them shortly. You can also see some of the buttons have changed too. On the left are PvP goals, and along the bottom we have a PvP shop, leaderboards, and alliances which aren't quite ready yet. Let's start.
I'm hoping this isn't going to completely replace PvP as we have it now.
With some basic PvP then. We select the central spire, choose a quick battle, pick an enemy, okay, and we're in. So far, it's quite similar to the old PvP system, apart from a few screen changes, which we'll get to. The one noticeable change is that we've removed casual PvP. Now, at the end of the PvP battle, we'll see you no longer get PvP score. Get victory points instead. We'll call them VP. VP are based on how difficult the battle is, and then you can see you get bonuses for various objectives. They're sliding in on the right. VP are used to rank you on the weekly leaderboard and to unlock things in the PvP shop. We have 2 new PvP currencies, silver marks and gold marks, only obtainable from PvP. You can see them up in...
Is it just me, or is this... I'm trying to place the accent. I want to say this guy's from either Australia or New Zealand. If that's the case, that's a bit of a surprise. I figured they were probably from, like, here in America or maybe England or something.
In the top right, you can also see a third one up there, but that'll be coming in a future update. You get silver and gold marks by fighting battles and completing goals, and you can spend them in the PvP shop. All right, the fun stuff. We mentioned there were 10 regions. Why 10 and how are they different? Well, each region has some different team restrictions for PvP to mix up the meta. The central spire, as you saw, has no restrictions, but the 3 inner regions have colored restrictions. And the 6 outer regions
have
human troop type restrictions, and they will change every week. There's also a bonus that floats around from region to region, where if you win 5 battles, you can get some extra silver marks. There's a limit to how many times you can do this per day, but as you advance, that limit and the amount of silver marks increases. Of course, you can still play as much PvP as you like, that hasn't changed. PvP goals replace the current PvP weekly rank system, and they behave quite similarly. Just keep collecting VP from battles over the week and see how far you can progress through the 20 goals. Many of the rewards are timed gold and soul boosters, and this is a great way to earn some extra weekly gold and silver marks. So what do we do with all of these gold and silver marks we're earning? We can spend them in the PvP shop. There are pets and rare resources.
Well, if it's anything like some of the other shops, yeah, the price is a little steep for what you get out of them.
Stuff planned, plus something new, talismans. Well, I say new, but talismans should be kind of familiar if you've played Underspire. They work exactly like trinkets, but in PvP. Let's take a look at these new PvP pets too. These ones provide team bonuses specifically for PvP, and specifically in regions.
Okay, so it's... I mean, they were already doing this, but it's kind of getting a really strong MMO... World of Warcraft, Final Fantasy 14 feel, where they're taking PvP, it's like a totally 100% different ballgame than it is PvE. Sometimes, some of these games I've played over the years, PvP and PvE are basically one of the same. The only difference is PvP, you can attack other players, and PvE, you can't. That's it. So,
we have 20 pets on release, 2 per region, and plenty more planned. Different ones will rotate through the PvP shop each week, but they are not currently available from pet knobs. Moving along these bottom buttons, we can see ladders and leads. The ladder is exactly the same as the old PvP leaderboard. It just adds some gold marks and silver marks as rewards. But the leagues are new and very exciting. Every week, you'll have 29 other adventurers to compete against. If you make it into the promotion zone, you'll move up towards Diamond League, where the best rewards are. There are a few other tweaks worth mentioning.
Yeah, so I think, Pinball FX3 has kind of like something like this too. Their weekly matchup league. Like, you beat enough high scores on there, you'll go from bronze to silver to gold. Can't remember what's after that. I want to say maybe platinum and then diamond. So, yeah.
There's no longer a defense team. With so many regions and things planned, it didn't make sense to keep picking all these defense teams. Other adventurers will now fight against the team you attacked with.
Okay, I heard defense. Let me back up a bit.
Against. If you make it into the promotion zone, you'll move up towards Diamond League, where the best rewards are. There are a few other tweaks worth mentioning, too. There is no longer a defense team. With so many regions and things planned, it didn't make sense to keep picking all these defense teams. Other adventurers will now fight against the team you attacked with.
There are no more
revenge battles. They didn't make much sense now. We'll have some great things coming to replace them. And that glory you used to get every day for logging in based on rank, it's now silver marks based upon your league. That, my fellow adventurers, is phase one of our new PvP system. We can't wait to hear your feedback, and we can't wait to roll it into the rest of the system as it takes shape in 2024. See you all on the...
Okay. Well, it seems it's going to be a big paradigm shift. It is one of my favorite things about this game, PvP, so... But I think you said it's going to happen over the course of next year. So, yeah. It isn't anything I'd probably lose sleep over right now. But it's going to be one of those where we'll have to cross the bridges when we come to them. Okay, but anyway, For the actual game stream, I'm gonna start things off with Moonkeeper, Keeper's Odyssey. It kind of suits the mood right now. So in the wake of all the things I talked about at the start of this stream, so
Shit, here we go again.
Hey, Tack. Long time no see. Still a bit burnt, huh? Thank you. more of them. I thought I heard him say that it's just gonna happen like over the course of next year. Yeah, basically one sinus congestion issues. Then secondly, somebody else, I don't want to say she's my coworker. I don't work with her. But somebody from a different department, she's got some kind of grudge against me, despite the fact that I haven't done anything to her. Just my mere existence offends her. But it's not a new issue. It's been going on. Apparently, it's been going on for like many years. Yeah, she's saying the same thing. Either that, or I must have missed that part in the video. I thought he said it was gonna take place over the course of like next year, like little tiny tweaks and updates here and there, and not like all of a sudden, all at once. I don't want to skip both of them. It's like two of the worst daily adventures you can get. Get a surge. I didn't get a surge, so we'll restart that shit. Good thing about doing these is just for the XP. I sure as hell don't need any gold keys. Okay. Oh, you're on the job. All right. Thank you. Okay, I gotta fire up my Discord. I totally forgot about it, so... So I'm on my Discord right now, just checking out the new stuff. Nothing else going on in the Discord. Might get lucky. Maybe. Run. What? Purple to yellow. start over. Nope. Stinky fucking bullshit. You got to go. Boy, did I ever get lucky on this one. For Joe. Ah, shit. Why did I totally mess that up? I thought it was for the Orb Weaver class. For help.
Uh-oh, retard alert.
It's for Stormcaller. I think this one's already above level 80, so. So much for that. Hope this is enough to one-shot him. Apparently not. I don't have a storm up, so. Thank you. one diamond. But not quite. Oh, shit. Let me do this. Not quite the way I wanted it set up, but... Ass! Ass! Pretty shitty board, yeah. We're really gonna get knocked the fuck around. Like, goddamn, man. I think I've had some pure faction fights that went quicker than this. Good thing this ain't a dull. think. Oh, green and blue, never mind. Singing something else. You gotta love it when something only stays up for one single turn. I can't read that. Kind of on a whim.
Thank you.
Surprise, surprise. Journey time. I had to get that trickster guy out of there, because he'll, I think he can jumble my team. Don't need my guys moving around. Thank you. Not a problem. Guess he had a lot to say, huh? Been there. I mean, I'm not an IT, but yeah, I make frequent screenshots. Like, if you ever seen any of my YouTube videos, a lot those the majority of those thumbnails I make myself. If you ever actually watched any of my old cast videos, a lot of the overlays and images that you see on them, I make them myself. They're all screenshots or GIFs, so yeah. Okay, I'm gonna switch over to another album. Yeah, not really feeling the chiptune right now. This is okay, I guess. This is like Aztec music. Just the bass drum. Pretty loud. Whoops. Bone Dragon, you gots to go. Yeah, same thing. I gotta target Trickster. Not so much for that. Gotta go. Oops, he's impervious. Still in second. Hell, it was super neck and neck yesterday. I think I'm still in second. Can't remember who it was. But yeah, he was ahead of me like 10 points. So. So yeah, I'm gonna, since I'm at a good stopping point right now, I gotta use the bathroom and then refill this. I'll be back. Switch to another album. Alrighty, so yeah, Guild Wars. Yeah, seems to be Red Day today. Well, two in a row that we've won. Yeah, that ain't good. We're frozen at the outset. And I also forgot to change metals, too. And because of the Centura gun and Zolgov combination, I'm anticipating this being a fairly easy one. Extra magic rating so much because it's a flat thing, same thing here, it's flat, there's no variable number in there, Zolgoth, same thing, it's unaffected by magic, maybe this, but looks like we might have a tough one here, though. We geared up for an anti-red team. Red. was it again? Moon of Red? Yeah, that's gonna be a problem. Round of Red? So, I believe we've already lost. Yeah. Oh, got lucky somewhere. Stinking hit point. Okay. So, commotion going on outside the door.
Mana surge.
Off to a bad start. Okay, I'm anticipating this being a shitty run. I'm gonna go 1-for-4. Nice to have had in the last battle. No. Well, you practically did blow damn near the whole entire board with Wanda Stars and still not get a fucking war match out of it. Yeah, it's more of the same again. Enough. Oh, nice tag. Not gonna hurt him, but I gotta put more skulls out there and then once again. Oh, hey, Dell. Yeah, it's like, I think with the exception of one team, all the rest of them, they're all specifically set up for Red Guild Wars, so some tough nuts to crack. Team score, 21k. I don't see that very often. The highest I've ever seen is about 20k, so. Like yesterday, 4-1. Well, kind of warms my heart a little bit. Top Paragon here is 3-2, 3-2. So far, Boris is in the lead. So I'm probably gonna be mid-tier. Yeah, a lot of 5-0s. I'll probably eternally stay down here at the bottom. I guess, since I'm here, so we'll go ahead and do the class trial. Wasn't planning on doing... I mean, at the time, I thought it was, me and my infinite wisdom, I thought it was the Orb Weaver class. But no, that was like a week or two ago. Whoops. So, I guess... Since I'm here, I think a Stormcaller is already above level 80. So I was kind of wanting to get a Orb Weaver to level 80, but it's like too late for that, so let me go ahead. Yeah, so I'll just do the first two tiers. I'm guessing it's gonna be my Under Spire team. Yeah. Can't use Finesse. They're from, they're Guardians. Hey, Screw. Yeah, four for one in Guild Wars. Or 4-1, I should say. Kinda. I cast Wand of Stars. It didn't backfire. It went off. Whole bunch of matches, but not a single one of them resulted in a four match. So, what just became his turn. And a good chunk of the teams were set up for Red Guild Wars. They had the Red Book, the Red Doom Book. Yeah, some of them saying it's supposed to be today. I thought I heard him say it was gonna happen over the course of about next year. yeah. Big time PvP overhaul. Terror? Not really into much. I mean, unless you're still gonna get the loot, like with gnomes. Yeah, more kingdoms to fight in, and more restrictions. Yeah, I saw that. It's basically another tier. Instead of like regular chromatic dragons, now it's cosmic ones.
They will fuel my fury.
Oh, hey, App. Long time no see, man. I've been doing all right. Now I'm working even fewer hours, going from 30 hours to 24. Not by choice. They decided just out of the blue. Can't work 10-hour shifts anymore. I gotta work tonight. It's part of the work week, but got home from work this morning, laid down. I only got like two and a half hours of sleep, and just had sinus issues. Plus, there's some stress in there as well. Just not some Asian girl who works at a different department. Has some kind of grudge against me. She's had that for years. It just kind of. She kind of got pissy with me this morning when I was coming off from lunch during the break. She said something like, "Stop staring at me." I couldn't make it out. She has a really thick Asian accent. And I really suck with accents, so. So bullshit's rearing its ugly head again. Now, I've actually been called to the office. Because of that.
Yes!
Oh, right there.
Huh?
You mean it wasn't on there before? Oh, hell, I thought you could play it on all the consoles, not just, not just PlayStation. Now, I'm gonna switch to another album. Yeah, close enough. Never knew that. Yeah. Yeah, I'll switch up and play other games, but as far as streaming goes, it's mostly this. I'll play like idle games and stuff like that. I was playing a game called Legends of Amberland. It's kind of a throwback to old school like dungeon crawl RPGs, but the monster power levels, or monster power, is actually exceeding player power. It's like, battles are now taking a lot longer for me. So it just... Plus, like the character levels, the gear they get, etc., isn't really enough to win the battles in like in a reasonable amount of time. It's like I have to spend a lot of time like going back to town and restocking, or trying to find a safe area away from all the rest of the monsters and camp, that kind of thing. So Legends of Amberland? Yeah, like I said, it was geared to where the battles were taking a long time to beat. So it's like I gotta set aside at least 30 minutes just to like clear out a dungeon or just to do a quest, that kind of stuff. Yep. Wizardry as well. Speaking of that. I found this fucking gem on YouTube one day. That's like a... It's like an old... 1985, I think. 1985 or 1987 on, it's a cassette rip. Dragon Warrior, Wizardry, there was also a Super Nintendo game called Arcana, and then Dungeon Master, it's probably one of my all-time favorite RPGs right there. I want to say, it's probably number two on my top five. But it's gotta be the Super Nintendo version, not the PC one. There's no music on that one. Yep. Might be in my top five. But, you know, it's gotta be pretty close up here. Yeah. It's one of the few instances where, or it's one of the few games where Bowser is actually the good guy and plays on your team. Yeah, I think I did the same thing too. Want to play like one console for a long time, but once I get another newer console, the other one just kind of falls by the wayside because I'm playing this one, and then so on and so forth. Yeah. Oh yeah. Black party hat? Yeah, I think they're all pretty rare. Oh yeah. Are you talking in real money? Oh, end game, okay. Because it wouldn't have surprised me either way. I reckon those party hats are probably about as expensive as that damn Black Lotus card in Magic the Gathering. Yeah, no such luck for me. Yeah, still have yet to get them. I gotta come up with about 2,000 Dragonite. Thank you. Yeah, but I think some of them, like some of those skins that you get in like various first-person shooter games, like Counter-Strike or whatever, yeah, they're worth a shit ton of money too. Recession? What recession? Actually, now that I think about it, it's gonna take a moment. I wanna pull this up. Yeah, it's gonna take a while because I'm streaming and stuff. Okay, some extra background noise might go on. I'll try to catch it. How's your call? Yeah, that's Emperor Lemon. He did a video on rare items. It's a pretty good vid. They're cracking down. I've had YouTube Premium, so yeah. Actually, now that you mention that. There was a certain video on here. It frickin' nailed it. I'm hoping it's in here. Okay, again, there might be some extra background stuff here. Background noise. Okay, I muted it. Yeah, the Cobra effect. Where it's had the opposite effect. And, definitely not the intended effect. Looks like... Yep. Yep. Yeah, that's pretty bad. Pretty bad when the FBI recommends ad blocker. Okay, so, let's do some PvP, and then, just the big goal. Yeah, I gotta get 3 levels to get this class to level 80. Don't know. I mean, with the hours I'm working right now, I don't see it happening. Yeah, I dread turning the computer on now. Especially if I gotta fire up OBS. There's a chance now that just starting up OBS will crash my computer. So. And, whenever I want to play back a video that I just made, I basically have to upload it to YouTube first, and then see how well it came out. I can't play back my own videos on here, because again, there's a chance that it'll actually crash my computer. Yeah. Yeah, for the one I was wanting to have, the price on it actually went down. At the time I made it, like some odd years ago, it was like 1500-ish. Took a look at it here recently, it got dropped down to like 600. But I still can't afford that though. I learned that lesson the hard way. You can't just buy an expensive graphics card and put it on a piece of shit computer. If you've got an expensive graphics card, or I should say, if you have a real powerful graphics card, you gotta buy a motherboard that can handle it. You also have to buy a power supply that can handle it. You have to buy a CPU, like the whole entire computer has to be that powerful as well. I actually did that recently, or not super recently, but yeah, I tried streaming it a while back. Still burnt. Yeah, I think a few weeks ago, I tried streaming pinball again, like in the morning, but I'm still to where I only want to, like, maybe record and upload, like, a couple short sessions or something. Like, one from a Pinball Arcade and Zachariah. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, I used to, way back in the day, TAC, that was, I used to stream pinball consistently, but it got too frustrating. I mean, I love pinball ever since childhood, but I'm at a point now where I can't be playing for long periods. It gets too frustrating. And there's been times where I have actually abandoned sessions because it got so bad, or I just got so pissed off. It just, you know, I don't want my viewers to be on the receiving end of that, so. Yeah, maybe if I had a new computer, I'd get pinball in, but like I said, right now my computer's almost, my computer's about as stable as nitroglycerin, so a lot of the games I have now crash. So it's one of the reasons why I've been playing Gems of War so much, because it's one of the few games I got that doesn't.
Our universe.
Matches. I gotta switch this up a bit. Yeah, there you are. This is an infinite loop team over here, so I have to kind of set it up a certain way. Way to start.
Ass!
I'll just keep the same team. For the hell of it. Gonna be a mirror match if I can find my team. There it is. Gonna be hearing that a lot. You didn't need it anyway. 7 stinking hit points. Yeah, 2 stinking hit points. Just to get her out of there. God, finally. Yeah, and I probably am going to be shutting down fairly soon. I'm starting to nod off. Good seeing you, man. Thanks for dropping by. See you next time, buddy. Too much of a good thing. Okay.
I've been there. Well, thanks for dropping by, Tech. Well, see you next time.
Just know that all. This is still my work week. So, tomorrow and Saturday, chances are pretty good I probably won't be on. So, I'll probably at the earliest, probably Sunday morning. Shit ain't cheap, is it? It's doing it again. Media player screwing up. Doing this to level the class. Fuck.
Oh.
Mirror match. Okay, probably gonna be my last battle right here.
not a single four match, huh? It's like Guild Wars all over again. So, luckily they got all, luckily they're all blessed. Blue. Oops, we got that shit to deal with. Well, that's going to do it for me, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and call it good. I'm starting to nod off, so yeah, definitely going to need to lay down here. Plus, I still need to get going on the my stream video here. I got to get that all prepped up and then exported to YouTube. So then I got to work on my blog as well. So yeah, there's that. But otherwise, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And again, this is the middle of my work week, so tomorrow and Saturday, don't be surprised if I don't come on. It just probably meant I wasn't in any condition to do so. So, which means you'll see me come on probably as early as Sunday morning. So, somewhere between 2 a.m. to as late as 5 a.m. I don't really have a set time for that anymore. It's just basically you'll see me when you see me. So, but until then, though. Thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time.